Yep.
Oh, this is the come up, man.
So, I brought a prop.
Sugar, all right.
It's unfortunately it's not the same as your album, but right? Why? Why sugar? Why did you come up with that?
It's just very easy to like come up with concepts around the title "Sugar" as to what you could do with it, and you know, obviously the sugar packets kind of what we decide on. That was the first design that our guy came up with, and it was just like, oh yeah, this is why yeah, we think about this from right, the very beginning.
I heard and the sugar importing companies were really happy with that. Yeah, because they got more revenue this year.
Perfect.
But you said simple, and I think that's true. I think that you're good at taking simple concepts that we all have in our daily lives and being like, bam, I bet you didn't consider it that way before. Right? I mean, and I like that, like cold beverages, sugar, yeah. Windshield wipers. Yeah. I mean, do you do that consciously or?
Well, I think, you know, as a songwriter, and if you ever read Keith Richards' book, he really says it well, because he says that like as a songwriter, you're kind of just a conduit. Like there's all this stuff floating around, you know, your daily routine in the universe, and ultimately if you can just open yourself up and let any of these catchphrases come into your mind, and then write them into a line. So yeah, like that song Windshield Wipers on new record, that's a good one. Like it's a mellow tune, like windshield wipers are driving my tears away. Like I just sitting in the car, my baby's mama just dumped me, I'm outside the studio, and you know, there's one of those rainy, cold nights in Philly, and the windshield wipers are going slow, and everybody knows that sound, you know?
Right.
This record was definitely like all supposed to be kind of a heartbreak record, and we recorded it, and I don't know, the label wasn't really feeling it, and the one tune they were feeling from the original session was the song Come Up Man. Anyway, so that made it easy, because then we said, okay, we're gonna do a song based around that, a record based around that song, which was basically a Cypress Hill style, a beat influenced by Cypress Hill, and Elmore James style slide guitar lick, mm-hmm. with me singing whatever's coming out of my mouth. And then, so that was gonna be the blueprint.
So what's the future for you?
Just continuing to play music and, just this, you know. I'd like to do this till I'm dead, you know. That's the future.
Why do you do it? What drives you every day?
When you step on stage, that's like a whole nother thing. That's like you're out there to do whatever you're trying to do with this room of people, whether that's to make them dance, or to make them laugh, or to make them cry, or to make them feel inspired, or whatever it is. You gotta, you know, ultimately though, the minute you step on stage, the first person you gotta prove it to is yourself. You know, some nights you go out there and you just, man, it's don't have it. Nothing's going right. You know, and some nights you go out and it's like the finale on the fireworks on the best 4th of July show you ever saw, you know. Elvin Bishop, Ronnie Wood from the Stones.
Nice.
Roy Rogers, some of Citizen Cope.
Really?
Keb Moe, who I just toured with. Nico right. from Edward Sharp. Wayne Cornsman, Flaming Lips. Jack Bear. But I have another one with like all the Beastie Boys on it.
Really?
This is my third signature guitar. I just get people to sign it when I'm on the road.
That's awesome. Did you sign it?
No, I didn't sign it.
Maybe it's time, man. I don't know.
Listen, man, thank you so much. For sitting down with me.
Pleasure. Thank you guys so much.
Yeah, for sure.
Right on.